So now I'm going to take a look to the melodic elements of the track. At first we have this melodic hang loop, which was played here. It's from Loop Cloud. This was the hang loop. I've took it like this and put an amp on it to give it a bit more drive, distortion, so it can be better fit in the mix. Some auto filter automation to fade it in and making just some small adjustments. Then this Valhalla reverb. Cutting out some lows and also putting a side channel on it. It's just played in the intro and outro to have a little bit more variation. And if I would have played it through the whole track, it would be very boring and wouldn't be any highlight thing in the track anymore. And that's the reason I put it in to this specific parts of the song. Then there's another hang loop. It's originally in B minor, so I had to pitch it one note up. It's played in complex mode. Also an amp on it. And also some reverb. And afterwards, sometimes if I want to fade out a stem, I used this FX chain instead of some return chains. Nowadays I do it in the opposite way, but there's in this time I wasn't really comfortable with mixing my track, so I had to do it like this. And it's also working like a return chain. So I've got this dry signal and this reverb signal. And you can fade it like just like with a return, you would do it here. You can fade it in with the utility plugin if you take it in front of the reverb. I did the same for a long delay. And together it sounds like this. To give a little bit more transitioning sound to the drop and fade out this element because it isn't played here anymore. Then there was this bass guitar. So I didn't need it, those upper highs. It was just too much for me. I just wanted to have it in the downside of the track to add a little bit more groove, put an amp on it, to give the lows more harmonics. And yeah, some volume automation for the arrangement, some side channeling of course, and also this tool like reinfused in the drums too. Then there's this FX pad. Okay, normally without any effects, it would just sound like this. It's the simplest mini preset. It's this 3 oscillator preset. and all I'm doing is just going up with a cutoff. But then I took an auto pan, put the amount to 100, a very high rate, and this strange random LFO. And then it sounds really, very, really interesting. Took out the lows. And also doing this FX chain kind of thing, just using a delay here and a reverb. Yeah. I didn't put any sidechain on it because I tried it and through the jam, because this is my jam session, I often keep it simple, and if I don't need it right now, so I just leave it and take it like it is. Then there is this vocal, which I've processed afterwards in the mixdown a little bit more because I thought there was some untuned stuff in it. And I also changed sometimes the first part of the vocal. Don't let the wretched surrender. It's also from Loop Cloud. Normally it would sound like this. Because this was recorded at 136 BPM, you have some stretching problems, but if you hear it in on solo, it sounds really strange and you wouldn't like to hear it, but in the mix you can't hear this artificial sound and it sounded quite nice, so I took it. Already you can see Waves Tuner. I wouldn't go too much into it because it wouldn't make too much sense. You just have to make it individually for your track. But it's quite a nice way also to process some flutes or strings, because WaveTunes Tuner works quite nice for stuff like that. And I pitched it for my personal taste. Then there's also a little bit of processing on it. I always like it to have a small room reverb on the vocal because it gives a little bit more the feeling of it was recorded in a room, and makes a little bit of vintage vibes in the tracks. And then this delay. So the vocal is fitting much better with the delay, because if the quiet parts are fitting better into each other, and I really like the sound, so I took it, and it's quite at minus 18 dB. It isn't too loud, so I liked it. I also had to stretch the vocal at the end, and that's why I like to keep my vocal like a backup vocal if I fuck up the stem in this part, in this section. And that's why I've also preset with all the plugins and just took the audio then. So it's the same audio. Then there was also some kind of backing vocal. This one is quite dry. Just some reverb and delay on it. And this one is the same vocal, but it just pulses it a little bit more. You can see already the FX chain is much louder, and of course the reverb is much longer. Yeah, almost 5 seconds long, and this one is not even at 1 second. Just a delay, but it's louder. Yeah, just the same sample. So at next, the bass line. It's quite untypical how I've made this bass line, because it was, for me at least, it is untypical because I've just took one note and worked with the pitch bend of my MIDI controller. Yeah, in this view I only have a sidechain on it. Played a little bit with the cutoff, as you can see here. You really have to take a look which parts the bass is too quiet, and you have to make it louder. So it's almost, mostly it's a good idea to turn up the cutoff and make it better in the mix. Then there's another loop. It's also from Loop Cloud, it's this flamenco guitar. This is the original sample. But I've pitched it one octave down, also used the complex mode, because it sounded quite nice. In this rough version of the track, there isn't any processing on it. No EQ or other things, but later I've added some things and it fits much better in the mix, but I will come back to that in another video. So there's also some automation, putting sometimes the lows out, the highs, also this kind of room reverb. Oh no, it's just the FX chain again. Here's the reverb, here's the delay. Then, because the drop is almost the same drop twice, the only thing that has changed was taking off the off shakers and in general the shakers, and didn't take this delay perks but this perks. So there needed to be a little bit more of a highlight. So I took the flamenco guitar and took it like it was before and mixed it under the down guitar. Just a tiny bit. So it sounds like this. At this point, I realized that I forgot in the previous video one percussion element. Which was... Yeah, actually I can't find it, okay. But I will come back to it later, of course. Ah, here it is. The cinematic. It's from Kontakt, a library I have. It's called Action Strikes. Normally it's made for making cinematic music, like composing music like Hans Zimmer or somebody. But I liked this deep toms and processed them quite a bit. Normally it sounds like this, putting an EQ on it. and there are two grooves, so there are only two patterns, which I took more than once in the track. So for example, this pattern isn't used here, but it is used here again. It's the same thing. Here it's another pattern. And because it wasn't enough for me, I also pitched up the cinematic pattern by one octave. Also shortened the transients. And now it sounds like this. It's almost working like a little layer to the original sound. And I only needed the first transient because this part, having it pitch up, it was too much, I think. It didn't work quite nice. Yeah, because of this stretching problems. So that's why I've kept it like this. And I also used this plus 12 pattern only a few times to have it more like a highlight in the track. So now we have this guitar also. Yeah. Then there's some white noise. It's by Keine Musik again. This time it's by Rampe. This is the original FX. Yeah, quite heavily. But sometimes FX sounds really fit good in your mix if they sound like this. And at first you don't like them because it's too much process, but in the mix almost you cannot hear every detail, so in general it sounds good. For example, I obviously had to make it fit into the song structure. It wouldn't sound nice if I just put it in here like this. So you can hear the difference. So I had to make it fit like I want. But you can achieve it quite easily. It won't be the exact way I did it in the production process, but just to showcase you. And then reverse it. And then you can fade it out and making the volume. Something like this. Then I've got this reverse piano. Yeah, it sounds quite nice. It's okay, I've got this contact library from Una Corda, and I just took the C note and pitched it one octave maybe down, or just took this tone in a low octave, and normally it would sound like this. Oops. Ah, like this. Okay, but I didn't need the first part, and also I've reversed it. And you can see the first transient is cut off a little bit. And then there's some heavy reverb on it. and delay again. And there's also some automation with the autopan. So I'm going up with the amount here and here again, and just playing with the weight of the LFO quite decent. It's not much doing, but the LFO is getting faster how the piano is panned from left to right. So you can hear it's very subtle. But it sounds quite nice if it's on. Then there's this woodwind kind of thing, which was actually the main idea. It was the sample. It's by Sampphonics. There's a full sample pack with sounds like this. And I only took some parts of it. Maybe I just use one sample, I don't know. And yeah, first of all, take all the process off. And you can okay, the mode I'm using is complex. I pitched every sample one octave down. And all I did was making kind of melody. And yeah, what you could have done a short pattern like this and repeat it, but it sounds boring quite fast. So the idea was to have till the drop a variation. So sometimes I use one pattern again, so one sample again, but in general, there's a little bit more variation instead of just repeating and looping a 4-8-bar loop. Then you don't need to have so much lows, so the EQ. Then a heavy reverb. Could be a little bit more or less afterwards, I thought, but yeah, it is like this now. Yeah, it sounds really atmospheric and nice. And there is some volume automation to fade it in. Also, I didn't know if I mentioned it, but I did some fade-ins and fade-outs so it wouldn't sound like just like this, for example. Oops. Let's take another part. Okay, I think we are done with everything. Yeah, should be.